such as the education for new membership, re-registrations, subscriber handbooks, media liaisons. That's very important in having a sound implementation of any of your projects or activities. I think one thing which is really good relating to claims is the existing of the clinical auditing. I think it's very important and it should be strengthened going forward and taking the process forward. And lastly, in terms of the positives, I think that the backbone of the IT systems have really been established. And that is really a commendable, looking at really the amount of resources which goes into IT and the backbone thereof. I think it will only require how do we encourage service providers to enhance their own ICT so that the issues of processing of claims and that can become e-claims. Now, in terms of the challenges which we have observed with respect to the presentations as well as being in the field and as our leader has talking about in terms of when we visited the private facilities is the issue of benefits that are very much comprehensive but are not consumerate to the premiums paid. So it becomes a real difficulty in terms of really maintaining and sustaining the comprehensiveness of benefits. We are of the opinion that looking at where the NHIS is currently in terms of the deficits, that intensive discussions need to take place with the ministry as well as Treasury so that those deficits can be covered and that you can still somehow have a sustainable financing mechanism for healthcare. Otherwise, we might have to, it might become that we go back to the cash, which we don't want to go to, which we don't want to go to. Saying all this, what are the possibilities which we can still look into with the current implementation and keeping within the environment as well as not exhausting your current available resources which is in place, is to look probably extending the call center to not only be for the clients but also the service providers to have a forum where they can probably have a discussion on some of these impediments in terms of health service delivery. I think we believe that the issue of clinical auditing should be more strengthened more. That will reduce the possible waste, fraud, and over-utilization. And then most importantly is always the issue of financing. I think that we are of the opinion that there is a better need for coordination with Treasury, between Treasury, NHS, Ministry of Health, to ensure sustainable inflows, particularly for the health sector itself. We do understand that there is this revenue collected, it goes into a pool and then only gets distributed to NHIS, which is a tedious process, a long process, and also fluctuates due to economic situations, exchange rates, and all that. And that means you don't have a dedicated funding directly to the NHIS itself. And this is where we are saying we need to protect the vulnerables. And hopefully that policy intervention or protection of the vulnerables could be engaged in such a manner that we stay with that direction. And I think the other most important thing which we observed is the pricing. Because in Namibia, we only use a single X price, which is equal to actual cost for prices of medicine or prices of drugs. So that fluctuation is not there and that wholesalers cannot come and bargain every time. So we've got that single exit price. I think in terms of how we really need to take this forward as a country, we observe that we've got quite a number of challenges, particularly getting the private service providers on board. That it will be one of our main challenge, because we all know that it's, the private sector is quite very strong and quite influential in the country. But it will be a big stepping stone as how do we get around it. Secondly is the issue, how do we educate the public in getting a mindset change? That means we need to restore the faith in primary health care with a focus on prevention rather than cure. Because when we do the national health accounts, it seems all our expenditures is going into tertiary inpatient and outpatient care, and not much money or not much inflows are in private prevention. What we need to look at is in terms of going forward, how do we define a workable benefit package with correct premiums? It's a challenge. I think what we are basing ourselves is that we've got private medical aides who are already there. We've got government who's there. How do we put all these benefit packages together so that it's workable? We don't crowd out the private sector, because we are saying we should keep the private sector. And then lastly, our issue is the referral system, which we believe should somehow be strengthened in the private sector as well as in the public sector. I think in the private sector, you come from a GP, a GP refers you directly to specialists. Obviously, within the public sector, we've got problems in terms of referrals from district hospital to tertiary hospitals, where somebody is referred from a district hospital but can't come to the referral hospital probably for 6 or 7 months down the line to acquire the services. So we really need to see how do we set up a good referral system which links up with any health insurance schemes which we have to undertake. So that is particularly then looking at our observation as well as our reflections as to where we are. And we say thank you very much for giving us this input and also giving us a sort of a direction as to where we can go as a country, or what we as a team can propose to our seniors in terms of where possibly we can go to as a country. I thank you.
Thank you. I believe you would have picked a lot of things, and hearing from the little that I just came and met, I appreciate that you had actually picked the key issues about healthcare delivery and healthcare financing. That's a very serious challenge, and no country can tell you that it has all it takes to resolve the challenges that come. We just manage them as and when they come. One key issue about Ghana's own system that will continue to pose a challenge for us has been the generosity of our benefit package. In actual fact, apart from the fact that it's generous, it's so ambiguous that it's easy to slot in whatever is not even captured, you know, because it's so broad and not specifically defined on each of the conditions that we will manage, and that is where the challenge is. That is where abuse can easily come in. So in designing benefit package, one thing you should observe is that they need to be specific on what you want. Providers will never be satisfied with whatever tariff you give them. They will never be. And you agree with me, with all apologies, with our wives who are here, that no matter the amount of chop money you give, when they come, they won't be changed. It's still that it was not enough. You know, so that is how providers behave. Fortunately for us, our system is portable. But you know African names. You know, I'm called, and then the African names facilitate computer fraud. Because if I'm called Anthony Gingong, and my brother Francis doesn't know that I have another name like Buitiem, and I go another way and say Buitiem Anthony, it takes me. So I'm registered there. Then I go to another facility and say Gingong Buitiem. So I can register 3 facilities. I can even have 3 different cards. You understand? That abuse is there. When you take the abuse out of our system, you are likely to bring down our claims payment by not less than 30%. If you're able to iron out. So when you are building the system, you have to look at that area strongly. Now, one other mistake we also did in our provider payment system when we're introducing capitation was to trade off medicines. We did not capitate medicines. Again, this is, at the OPD level, we should be able to capitate medicines. Unfortunately, we did not do that. So what do you see? That if you do, and I'm happy Francis is doing some work now, if you do quick analysis, rapid analysis of trends, you realize that suddenly cost of medication has gone high. In fact, higher in the capitated areas than non-capitated areas. So what are providers doing? All they are doing is that, okay, if I can't get you in service, I'll shift it to the medicines. If you go to the regions that hitherto had even race reservations, they are accepting it. And the other regions that we are going, they even think that we are slow. Because healthcare managers have begun to realize that capitation improves quality of care, right? And I'll give you a typical example that we were in a community. And to give a deba, and one of the community members got and said, oh, I'm so happy that you are bringing capitation. Now, the nurses who are here, I hope you heard, if you don't treat us well, we'll go to the other facility and register and run away and leave you. You know, and I like the response from the nurse. He said, oh, this one, it compares both of us to behave well. If you people, if you don't also behave well and you come, I'll refer you. You understand? So it brings checks and balances, you know. And the mere fact that the subscriber has the right of choice as to where he wants to enroll with compels people to now work. In actual fact, facilities that were one-man station, recently when I went, they had posted more staff to add. Because if it is not 24-hour service, people will not choose as their preferred primary provider. So yes, in designing your system, you need to look at all this. And then also, you also need to work seriously against the possibility of abuse. I think that Ghana's health insurance needs a total review, a total overhaul. And that it needs an overhaul because from the trend we are going, no amount of money pumped into the system can actually take us off our financial gap. Any policy we introduce now is going to be temporal. You know, I have heard arguments like, why don't you increase VAT? If you increase VAT, I'm telling you, if you even increase it by 2.5, the next 5 years, we will need to increase it again, looking at the growth. So we need to design policy. If we want to concentrate on primary care, let's concentrate on primary care and put in mechanism to address issues of people who cannot afford going beyond primary care. Otherwise, this general and unlimited benefit package is not sustainable. So our whole health insurance needs to be reviewed and looked at, and then it can become sustainable. On that note, I want to join my colleagues to say you're welcome, and I'm ready to respond to any question that hitherto. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you very much for the opportunity. On behalf of the Chief Executive, just want to give a brief remark to close this important meetings that we have had with you. I must say that we are very grateful for selecting Ghana as your place of visit. And I believe all the information that I've been given here, you are very much satisfied. There are a couple of things that probably we want to highlight, which has reflected in the presentations and in some cases your remarks. The first one is to see the whole process as a national agenda and not the political agenda as the minister told you when you visited him. Once you all see it as a national agenda, you have the buy-in of all stakeholders. And once you have the buy-in of all stakeholders, you are likely to reduce some of the challenges that you'll be facing in course of the implementation. Now, the other thing is about the private sector involvement. Here, we want to stress that you really need to consider the private sector, both from the health insurance side and the provider side. What is important is to get clear rules and regulations to govern the process so that the private sector knows where to start and where to end, and then the public sector also knows where to start and where to end. At the end of the day, it is the collaborative effort of both the private and the public that gives the national goal that you want to achieve. Then you also mentioned about workable benefit package. I like the adjective workable. Workable benefit package. Ghana, we started with a benefit package that I may say was not clearly defined, because you go to the LI, it mentions the benefits package that we have, But then it also goes to mention exclusion list. So if you have a litigant, you will just look at the exclusion list and then conclude that anything that is not in the exclusion list should be part of the benefit package. But you ask yourself, are you able to cater for all the conditions that exist in your country within the concept of health insurance? Because health insurance should not be the only mode of paying for healthcare services. So you may want to consider that. And then you also mentioned about the referral system. I think one way to strengthen the referral system is to choose very good provider payment system. And Mr. Gingon has elaborated on some of the positive effects of capitation. And I believe that capitation is a payment system that will help to reinforce the referral system. Because right from the beginning, you are tied to a provider. So the provider becomes your primary point of call whenever you are sick. And therefore, from there, you could be referred to the next level. So that system enhances the referral system that you have already in the system. And probably the last and not the least is an advice to consider sustainability analysis right from the beginning. You may project over a period of 10 years, but the advice is that as you move along the implementation, you review it periodically, because it's a function of time and the conditions and resources that we have at your disposal at any point in time. On that note, we'd like to wish you a very safe journey back home. And we want to indicate that our doors are quite open. Anytime you want to come, we are happy to receive you. And we also want to spread the news across the Southern African region. Any country within that region that wants to come to Ghana, you are very much welcome. Thank you very much, and safe journey.